I'm glad we're having a discussion about taxes because everybody laments that we lose jobs overseas. Well, yeah, our companies and our jobs are being chased overseas by a 70,000-page tax code. So that's why I've chosen to get rid of the whole thing and have one single rate, 14.5% for everybody. If you want boots on the ground and you want them to be our sons and daughters, you got 14 other choices. There will always be a Bush or Clinton for you if you want to go back to war in Iraq. But the bottom line is the states, we say we like the 10th Amendment until we start talking about this. And I think the federal government's gone too far. I think that the war on drugs has had a racial outcome and really has been something that's really damaged our inner cities. Bernie Sanders is offering you free stuff. He wants to give you free health care. He'd give you a free car. He'd give you a free house. But guess what? There is no free lunch. That just means somebody else is paying for it, but they're not showing you who's paying for it. We're gonna have to figure out how to take our message, not dilute it, but take our message to new audiences, and I will get it done. You see, there's a relationship. The smaller your government, the bigger your freedom. The bigger your government, the less freedom you have. It's exactly how it works. But the vast majority of you are not for this. So why does it happen? Because you leave your people in Washington too long. We should term limit them all, fumigate the place, and bring them home. What I'm trying to inject, and I am a solitary voice on the stage running for president, trying to inject some common sense into our foreign policy.
As I go down the list of candidates that I think have got what it takes to fix my party and to fix Washington, D.C., there's really only one, and it's the guy I'm here to introduce. Ladies and gentlemen, my candidate for president, Rand Paul.